The moment I saw what SoftrAI App Generator could do, I already knew I wasn't going to win. But I was curious, how badly would I lose? As it turns out, very bad. I've been developing apps for 8 years and this is how I got absolutely f***ed by AI. Just how much of a difference does AI make with no-code app building? My scriptwriter and I decided to test this out with a friendly little contest. Who can build an app faster? Me, Mr. Full Stack Developer with 8 years of experience, or Ashraf, a pleb with zero coding knowledge?
Round one, fight!
To keep the comparison valid, we kept all other variables constant. We used the same tech stack, software for our front end, Google Sheets for our database. We also built the same app. The only difference is that Ashraf gets to use SoftrAI App Generator while I need to create the pages manually. And because I'm a gentleman and a scholar, I let him choose what app to build. Looking at Software's areas of focus, Ashraf settled on building a directory of Malaysian fish shops for fish keeping hobbyists. He's a big fish keeping nerd and it's a legit use case. And if it was just me vs Ashraf, even with no code, I know I would smoke him. Let the games begin. Okay, on the left, you're looking at Ashraf using SoftrAI App Generator. One thing to note is the prompt has a 200 character limit, so he needs to be economical with his words and focus on the right priorities. Notice that he specifies what visitors should be able to see in the directory entries. The app suggests a name, Ashraf chooses a suitable color, and voila, he's got a fully functional directory front end here, labeled and connected with each other. His front end was ready in 1 minute with about 20 seconds of him doing any work at all. Meanwhile, you can see me on the right getting started with choosing some pre-built pages. I need three: a homepage with a search function, a submission form, and a page for individual directory entries. And shit, I've already lost to Ashraf. Okay, gotta make these pages look fishy. I'm editing the styling and sections of the pages here. Pictures, copy, getting the aesthetic sorted out. Okay, I didn't have AI, but I had Software's stock photo assets to lean on. That's a small win. I chose the Oscar fish since my directory is definitely Oscar worthy. The entry list needed to be changed. Okay, the home page looks close to finish. Now to style the other two pages and connect them. Let's speed up the video here. Okay, I'm done with the front end, clocking out at just under 21 minutes. And it was me working the whole time. 21 minutes for me versus 60 seconds for Ashraf. If I wasn't my own boss, I would have fired me and hired Ashraf. Nah, screw Ashraf. I would have hired the AI generator. Yo, that AI app generator is sick, and I know you want to play around with it. For those who are interested, link is in the description. Go ahead, sign up for an account, and check out the SoftrAI App Generator. If you're already sick of listening to me, go ahead, leave a like and a sub on the way out. You're still here? I guess I'll have to say more stuff about what just happened. Starting with obviously a huge difference in speed. And I think the real beauty here is how easy it is to specify your app to any niche. Cause you want to narrow down. You want to cater to a specific community. But as a rule, the narrower you go, the more manual work you should expect to do. And if you are like Ashraf, with no design or tech skills, your app might suffer from, how do I say this kindly? Less than ideal UI UX. You'd be Adrian, the one who had to run around looking for the right pictures, information, getting the content and design right. So basically, you would have two choices: spend extra time and effort to get it done right, or rush it and risk showing your users a less than ideal app. I think we can agree the right choice is to spend the time to do it properly. But now, AI assistance seems to be a legitimate third choice. Case in point, SoftrAI App Generator can probably cater to any niche for you in seconds. Whatever Ashraf would have wanted to create within reason, he would have had almost immediately. This is some Genesis, let there be light kind of And what is a developer like myself who's only flash and blurred compared to the almighty powers of an AI-powered Ashraf? In the battle of developer versus AI for early stage front-end development, Adrian has been spanked on both cheeks. As it is, the app is 90% finished, just needs a backend. Let's see it through and complete it. We've seen how SoftrAI App Generator helps make front-end app development a breeze. Time to see how simple it is to build your backend or database. Finishing up the app. Raise your hand if you don't know Google Sheets. Everyone knows Google Sheets. Everyone uses Google Sheets. My grandma uses Google Sheets and she died 20 years ago. Sorry, Papa. As I was saying, Google Sheets is extremely widely used because it's very intuitive. For apps like directories, internal tools, and other common software use cases, a Google Sheet is also often a good enough database. No fancy functions needed, you just want somewhere that data can be sent to and somewhere data can be pulled from. Software makes it very easy to connect your app to a Google Sheet, and the SoftrAI App Generator makes one for you. You just need to give it permission and voila! Here's a Google Sheet ready to receive submissions through the form. And the directory section itself automatically pulls from the sheet too. What does this mean? It means you can have a fully functional app, front-end and back-end, in minutes. Guys, and I say guys because 92% of my viewers are dudes, allow Uncle Adrian to share an uncle's perspective. And to the 8% of female viewers, hello my lady. Permit this chivalrous white knight to do some mansplaining. When I first started out as a developer, no code was already around, but not like this. If Ashraf had wanted to build a fish shop directory and look half as decent as this, he would have needed to hire someone like me, and it would have cost him thousands and taken me a few days to a week. And if his developer didn't know anything about fish keeping, it would have been yet another challenge as Ashraf would need to explain what fish keepers wanted. And yet here, Ashraf in 2023, with zero coding knowledge, does not need any thousands, and it's done in 10 minutes. Now, that's great, but how many founders do you know became success stories in 10 minutes? Zero. So, where does Ashraf go from here? Well, one of two paths. There's always a chance his app doesn't gain traction, it's part and parcel of being a founder. But let's say it does. Ashraf has nailed his market and Malaysian fish keepers see his app as the number one directory in Malaysia. If that's the case, I'm sure as time goes on, Ashraf will need to expand the app with new features based on user demand. That could be months or even years from now. What's certain is that if he never built anything today, Ashraf would never get there. For me, this contest with SoftrAI App Generator has been one of the most impressive demonstrations of how much no-code has lowered the barrier to entry for non-tech folks. If we look at Software's showcase, we can see there are other areas of focus. So if you have an idea for a portal, internal tool, marketplace, or directory, get it made in 10 minutes and let the market decide if it's worth pursuing further. Just leave fish-related directories alone. Ashraf wants a complete monopoly on that. Guys, if you found this video useful, please subscribe and leave a like. I would like as many non-tech founders as possible to see it. If you didn't like it, be sure to hit the thumbs down button twice, just to be sure. So you've just seen SoftrAI App Generator in action. Pretty cool stuff. If you want to check it out, sign up via the link in the description. But you still need to think up ideas, and for that, I recommend my video on finding app ideas based on market gaps, aka unsolved problems. Come on, AI is already doing all the work, just do a bit of thinking. Leave a like, subscribe, and let's find some million-dollar problems to solve.